Kampala Capital City Authority and all concerned authorities in the cities across the country are soon stopping approving plans for single and double-roomed houses. Once this proposal becomes effective, it will become mandatory for the city landlords to construct only apartments or high-rise buildings for the tenants. Addressing journalists today in Kampala, the State Minister for Lands, Housing and Urban Development, Pasis Namuganza, explained that the move is intended to provide better planning housing infrastructure in the city and gradually eliminate slums.
Land acquisition and a holding place. What we don't want is when we start construction of these houses is to evict people and they have nowhere to stay. So we are going to start with model houses whereby they will become holding places. That if somebody has been staying in Kasokoso, we have done construction somewhere in a phase, and we shall do this in a phased manner, and those people are shifted to those houses. And then where they have been, for example, in the slum areas, construction takes place. If they want to come back, they can come back to those places.
This new initiative of planned settlements comes at the backdrop of the failed Nakawa Nagru estate, where government evicted people with plans to construct better housing units. Unfortunately, over 10 years down the road, this plan has never been executed. Minister Namuganza attributed the challenge to mismanagement, giving assurance that this time round they'll be able to put into action all the new plans regarding better settlements in the cities.
You had people blaming me about Nagulu, how I have sold land in Nagulu. Nagulu, people were evicted. I don't know that time where I was. I just learnt about Nagulu when I was in the ministry. At that time when they were removing people from Nagulu, I was not even paying attention. I was in school. Now, when I come in and I find a lot of issues in place, multiple allocation of land and all that, which I don't want to go into. And then for me, I just see that really, this Nagulu issue was mismanaged from the beginning. Because people came with a different intention. And along the way, they changed it. And no one was there to check. Until of recent, when the cabinet said that, no. The real intention of giving out Nagulu was to construct affordable houses like what you're talking about.
But currently, urban centers have a housing deficit of 2.5 million units, and that's why government is moving in quickly to address this challenge. First, they have partnered with Buganda Kingdom to construct affordable houses for the low-income earners.
Buganda District Land Board, the Buganda Kingdom, has accepted to partner with us because some of these lands where you see slums, they don't belong to government, they are not public, but they belong to Buganda Kingdom. So the Buganda BRB, Buganda Land Board, fronted by the Buganda Kingdom, they are with us in these discussions. And they all agree that really we should address the housing concerns by eliminating all these slums to put up better accommodations for Ugandans, and they own them at the cheapest price possible.
The development comes ahead of the second edition of Uganda Build Corn International Expo, which will run from the 10th to 12th of this month. During this expo, focus will be put on architecture, construction and machinery, building materials, engineering and innovation, interior designs, heavy equipment and hardware, tiles and ceramics, government's construction-related programs, policies and regulations, among others. Connect with the construction industry to build a better tomorrow is the theme of the expo. Report by Jaliat Namoya for the news.